Hi, this is Farooq Hashmi from thinkingneuron.com. In this video, I will help you understand about AIC and BIC. So let's get started. First of all, let us talk about where this is used. So AIC and BIC, these are goodness of fit measures. Goodness of fit of what? So goodness of fit for classification use cases, especially the logistic regression algorithm. So when you create a logistic regression, when you create a logistic regression model, or as such any model which is based out of maximum likelihood estimation. So we know that this is the cost function for logistic regression, just like we have sum of squared errors for linear regression. In logistic regression, what we try to maximize is this likelihood. So we select that model or those parameters, those coefficient of my equation where my log likelihood is maximized. So based on this log likelihood, the AIC and BIC is computed. Just like in your linear regression, you compute R squared value based on your sum of squared errors and the total variance. Here, based on the likelihood or the log likelihood, you compute AIC and BIC. And you choose that model, that logistic regression model, which has the lowest AIC or lowest BIC. These two terms are actually connected with each other. So let's say you are creating a logistic regression model, and in the first go here, this is your target variable, that whether the loan will be approved or whether the loan will be rejected, and these are, let's say, four predictors which you have. So in the first go, you created a model with just predictor one. In the second go, you used predictor one and predictor two. In the third go, you used predictor one, predictor 2, predictor 3, and predictor 4 all. So for each of these scenarios, you have measured the AIC and BIC, both. So let me just take the example of AIC. Let's say for predictor 1, the AIC came out to be 1500, here it came out to be 1000, and here it came out to be, let's say, 1200. So you select that model which constitutes of two predictors, because this model is giving you the lowest AIC out of all the choices. Now there is no absolute lowest value of AIC, simply because this is a relative measure. So on different data sets, different scale of AIC will be generated. So out of all the choices which you have, out of all the different models of logistic regression which you have created on the same data, choose that particular version which has the lowest AIC or the lowest BIC. You can choose any one of them, both will work just fine. All right, now coming to the formulas of these, how do we estimate these, how do we calculate these AIC and BIC? So AIC is basically short form for Akaike's Information Criterion, and this is equated as minus 2 multiplied by the log likelihood. So log likelihood is computed whenever you create a logistic regression model, so multiply it with that, and then k into number of parameters. So k is 2 when you are calculating AIC, and the same k is log of n, where n is the total number of rows in the data, when you are computing BIC. So Bayesian information criteria or criterion is basically using a k value which is different from the AIC. So that is the only difference between AIC and BIC, the value of K which you use here. This K is slightly different in BIC. It is the log of number of rows, and over here it is 2. In AIC it is 2. Number of parameters which you multiply is same in both. It is the number of columns. Alright. So I hope AIC and BIC is clear to you, and you'll be able to explain these two terminologies in your interview with confidence. So all the best for that.